Dear chess friends, welcome to Azarov Chess Channel and welcome to a new and spectacular gameplay by the latest version of Stockfish, the powerful Stockfish 16. Today we see the fish battling it out against another top engine, Alexandria NNUE, in an amazing Makagonov variation of the King's Indian Defense. But the cool part is that we'll see again the fish battling it out here with the black pieces in the King's Indian Defense. And before we start to analyze the game, I wanted to show you this current position. This position will happen in this particular game, but I wanted to ask you a question: would you believe me when I would say to you that the dark square bishop on g7, that's actually here in this particular position the worst minor piece on the board, will become simply the best minor piece on the board? So this will be pure magic how Stockfish will manage to get this bishop into the game. So pay good attention. In my opinion, again, a wild position of the game, but then afterwards really a spectacular tactical gameplay by Stockfish 16. So let's start from the beginning with the white pieces. The Alexandria chess engine opened with move d4, Stockfish was possible, knight to f6, c4, g6, knight to c3, bishop to g7, e4, and after move d6, we have now the King's Indian Defense, of course, controlling so far the e5 square. We have h3, the so-called Makagonov variation. This move leaves white a certain flexibility in the game to even attack the king side with potential ideas like g4. This move h3 also prevents the move knight to g4, because white wants to play in many occasions the move bishop to e3, then of course the bishop can be kicked away with potential knight to g4 move. But this move is very, very tricky because, as I said, it makes already progressive ideas here with the move g4 by white. Stockfish continues with kingside castle. We have bishop to g5. Usually the main line should be something like a6, maybe c6, b5, hitting the flanks here, but Stockfish continued here with the normal idea. h6 doesn't want to tolerate this bishop on this active square. We have bishop to e3, e5, normal ideas of the King's Indian breaking and entering here in the center of the board, trying of course to somehow release the pressure in the center of the board, because white is already storming with these three pawns in the center of the board. Here we have d5. Of course, in these types of structures, white is always the advantage. White is always the space advantage, has at least some pawns on our side of the board. Stockfish continues now with a very important idea that's a must-know idea, I think, when you're King's Indian Defense player. a5, with the idea to reroute the knight on a6 and then to fix it on c5, and then also to play something like knight from f to d7 and then control really the c5 square, maybe even push the pawn further in some lines when you remove the knight, also to play maybe f5, f4. So these are strategic concepts here for black. We have g4 by Alexander immediately. Very tricky stuff, already a very aggressive line, which makes, I think, also this move f5 for black a little bit harder. So now Stockfish has to search for different opportunities. We have knight to a6 by the fish, knight to f3, knight to c5, hitting now the pawn on e4, and here Alexandria reroutes now the knight and protects the e4 pawn. We have c6. Stockfish doesn't want to tolerate, of course, the spaces here in the center of the board. White should actually not recapture this pawn on c6, because here after b takes c6, okay, maybe there is a certain weakness in black's camp. Maybe there is a weakness on d6, but this weakness can, I think, be really easily improved with queen to c7, rook to d8, and I think white didn't gain anything. Messed up the main advantage that you had, really the space advantage. Now you don't have any more pawns on the fifth rank. Now you have already pawns, only pawns on the fourth rank. So here after move after move c6, Alexandria continued with the move a4. This move is of course not allowing here by black also to push the pawn further, but this move creates several dark square problems here in black, in white position, and this this weakness is Stockfish will try to exploit. Stockfish will try somehow to attack this dark square problems. We have rook to a6 by the fish, immediately trying rook to b6 and occupy here also maybe in some lines the b3 weakness. We have b3 by Alexandria. Stockfish continues with rook to b6, bishop to e2, and now as promised, this maneuver of the knight from f to d7, very important move, because with this move g4 already that white has played, if you don't react here, if you don't move your knight, then this move g5 comes with the tempo, and now the h file is going to be open. So that's why knight to d7, very, very important move to not allow g5 here by white. We have queen to c2, and now comes an amazing move here by the fish. Stockfish plays an amazing knight to a6. sacrifices here the exchange, but Alexandria didn't want to take it out because actually after something like bishop to b6 and queen to b6, we can notice now that this dark square problems are getting more and more intense, I think, in white's position, and you're now only left with the light square bishop, and you have many pawns on the light squares. So in this positional trades of pieces, I think white will not be so good, especially because of this really, really bad bishop that's stuck, that's really immobile, that's really paralyzed by its own pawn structure. So that's why here the rooks, I think, don't play such an important role, because this position is in the center is blocked out, the position in the center is static, you'd have really a tough time to open the position. And now the queen is also hitting here the weak f2 pawn, and here, as I said, in a couple more moves, white could have really problems also on dark square. So that's why after move knight to a6, Alexandria didn't dare to take out now the rook, played simply queenside castle. We have knight to c5 by the fish. Stockfish is saying, you had your chance, now my knight is really fixed here on this side of the board. H4, Alexandria of course makes progress here on this side of the board, and we have now bishop to d7, and after move h5, you don't want to of course open files in front of your king, so that's why Stockfish passes through and plays now the move g5. But as I said in the beginning, the dark square bishop becomes now really almost the worst piece on the board. But look how the fish will improve in an epic way this dark square bishop. Now the real fun starts. We have here queen to a2. Now Alexandria, after queen to c8, played, I think, its first mistake, played now the move bishop to c5. Really an unnecessary move, giving up the dark square bishop for the knight. But maybe Alexandria calculated that this bishop on g7 is really a bad bishop, that it cannot be included into the game. Maybe here Alexander also searched maybe for some improvements to play knight to f1, knight to g3, knight to f5, rerouting the knight on an active square, and then maybe make something here on this side of the board. Giving up the bishop for a knight was, in my opinion, the crucial positional mistake, and I think from this point on, black is simply taking over. We have knight to c5. As I said, the bishop is still a bad piece, but now, as I said, the fun starts. Rook from d to g1 here by Alexandria, and now Stockfish improving simply the minor piece all over the board. Stockfish improves again the piece. Stockfish is searching now this square for the bishop, the beautiful d4 square. And the problem, again, I'm pointing out for white is here that you have the rooks, but you cannot open files. You can, of course, play f4, but then after something like, I don't know, e takes f4 and bishop to f6, this dark bishop again becomes a good piece. So opening files is actually here not possible, and the rooks really hate these types of close position. The rooks are not, as I said, so important in this particular position. We have rook to h3, we have knight to a6, we have king to b1, bishop to c7, queen to d1, we have bishop to b8, we have here rook to f3, and now after bishop to a7, Stockfish is searching now for the d4 square. Stockfish is now going for this beautiful square that I think Alexandria left behind, and from this point on, I think the bishop, the dark square bishop, the really bad piece becomes actually now the best minor piece on the board. Really, really wild stuff. Rook from g to g3. We have queen to d8 controlling some moves like rook to f6. We have bishop to d3. And now rook to b4. Stockfish finally liberates the long diagonal for the light square bishop. And now the dragon is coming into the game. We have knight to a2. Stockfish ignores the threat. Again, gives up now the exchange. Knight to b4, knight to b4. But as I said also, the rooks are not so important. Look at this. Where are you going to go with the rook? You can play maybe, I don't know, somewhere rook to f5, maybe giving up the exchange back, but it doesn't matter. This beast now, this bishop becomes, as I said, simply the greatest attacker of this position. Queen to f1, bishop to d4. We have queen to e2, queen to c7. Stockfish exploits further the dark square problems of white. If you play here rook to f6, it doesn't matter. We'll simply play king to g7, and you have to maybe something like rook to f3, but now bishop to g4. It's very dangerous, so this tactic is simply not working here for white. So that's why after queen to c7, queen to d1, we have queen to b6, rook to f6 now finally, and now bishop to f2, hitting now also the rook on g3. What should white do? You can, of course, play something like, I don't know, rook to f3 here, but then bishop to e3 disconnects the rook from the defense of the bishop. You can maybe play something like bishop to e2, but now bishop to f4 locks out now the rook, and this is, in my opinion, again, a devastating position for white. Even if you give up now, finally, the exchange back for the bishop, then again, as I'm pointed out also in the beginning, your light squared bishop is always paralyzed by all of this pawn. So here black's light squared bishop is much better, because it attacks actually our opponents here pawns all over the board. So that's why even rook to f3 is not working here. So that's why Alexandra tried rook to h3. Stockfish plays again this idea, king to g7, kicks away the rook. We have queen to f3, connecting now the queen to the rook, and now knight to d3, simply picking up the piece, hoping of course to deflect the queen from the defense of the rook on f6. But Alexandria calculated, I think, also this position in a decent way. Played now rook takes d6. Stockfish plays queen to d4. Is trying to protect, of course, the knight on d3. Alexandria takes. Stockfish plays now bishop to g4. Is hitting now the rook. We have d takes c6. Everything is pretty much forced here. Stockfish takes the queen. Here, Alexandria also takes out now the queen. We have b takes c6. And now, after king to c2, Stockfish grabs now a very important pawn. In any other case, I think this would not be a good continuation for black, but actually now we have two bishops that are supporting two passers, two connected passers on the king side, and I think this game becomes simply one-way ticket here in white's favor. So it's really, really bad here. As I said, instead of this move king to c2, you could maybe try rook takes c6, but again, the same pattern happens. You can maybe include this rook into the game. Now we simply push to play this beautiful setup with our bishops, and slowly but surely we just push the pawn, and I think the rooks cannot catch up anymore with the g-pawn, especially also if necessary, the h-pawn will be also included into the attack. So here after b takes c6, as we said, king to c2, bishop takes h5, rook to h3, and now bishop to g6, not allowing also this h6 pawn to be taken here by white. Rook to f3, bishop to d4, Stockfish fixes again the best minor piece on the board. Very, very wild stuff how Stockfish rerouted the bishop all over the board. Rook to g3, and now f5. Now comes the common, the liberating, the most progressive move in the King's Indian defense. Stockfish waited for this move through the whole game. Now finally it's possible, and also the king is lined up here against the bishop. So from this point on, really, really a bad game here for white. So we have e takes f5, bishop to f5 comes with the check. Stockfish is of course pushing the pawns. Now Stockfish wants of course also to trade off the rooks, because these pawns are too much to handle here for white. After knight to f3, Stockfish even fixes here the bishop on c on d4 with the pawn move c5, king to e1, bishop to e6, rook to d6, and here after move h4, in this particular position here Alexandria resigns. So what's the problem? Of course, if you play here knight takes h4, then bishop to f2 is simply winning the game. We pick up the rook, and while black is continuing then the game with the whole piece up, and the bishops are of course again supporting the g pawn, it's game over here for white. So as I said, after move h4, in this position Alexandria resigns. So great first of all, positional game, I would say, because Stockfish had really some problems, positional problems, how to activate the pieces, but the path of the bishop was really, really incredible, in my opinion. Very instructive game in the King's Indian, how to exploit these dark weaknesses, how to evaluate your pieces, because we saw that in some lines, in some positions, the rooks are worse than minor pieces, because the position was simply too blocked out. Stockfish recognized it and played here really, really this brilliant King's Indian defense chess game. So okay, I hope that you enjoyed this game. I really enjoyed it a lot. Interesting ideas of the King's Indian for sure. If you want to see more epic, beautiful, positional, spectacular tactical games, check out our Come the Chess Games Play by Computer series. Here's the link of our playlist, and if you like this content, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. See you soon with some more videos, and what do we say in the end? Chess is the best, of course.